ओके, इन लेक्चर 5 वी विल डिस्कस 3 आर्टिकल्स. वन इज द रोमांटिक इमेजिनेशंस, द रोल ऑफ आर्ट एंड कल्चर इन नेशनलिज्म. सेकंड इज हंगर, हार्डशिप एंड पॉपुलर रिवोल्ट. एंड थर्ड इज फ्रैंकफर्ट पार्लियामेंट ऑफ 1848. So let us start today's first article, the romantic imagination and national feeling, or the role of art and culture in developing national feeling. This point we will discuss in 5 points. So first point to this article is the development of nationalism did not come through wars and territorial expansion only. Culture also played an important role in creating the idea of the nation. How? Like art and poetry, stories and music helped express and shape nationalist feeling. Second point, the romantic artist and poets generally criticize the glorification of reason and science and focused on emotions, intuitions, and mystic feeling, religious feeling of the people. They put their efforts on shared collective heritage, a common cultural past, as the basis of nation. So basically, in this, past heritage and culture was used. Third point in this is the other romantics, such as German philosopher John Gottfried Herder. He claimed that true German culture was to be discovered among the common people. It was through folk songs, folk poetry, folk dances that the true spirit of the nation was popularized. So, these folk cultures were collected and recorded, and the vernacular languages were given importance. Vernacular languages, local languages which were spoken by the local people. Fourth point to this is, in case of Poland, which had been the part of Russia, and a revolution against Russian language was launched in 1831. As Polish language was forced out of schools and Russian language was imposed. So this was the revolution against Russian language in Poland, because Russian imposed Russian language and Polish language was disbanded. So following this, many members of clergy in Poland began to use language as a weapon of national resistance. Karol Kurpinski, for example, celebrated the national struggle through his operas and music and turning folk dances. And last point in this, you can mention Grimm Brothers also saw French domination as a threat to German culture and believed that folk tales they had collected were expression of a pure and authentic German spirit. In 1812, they published their first collection of tales. So basically, in this role of art and culture, we discussed four artists, that is John Gottfried Herder, who used German culture, Karol Kurpinski, who used folk dances, operas, music, turning folk dances, etc., and Grimm Brothers. They were the two brothers who visited village to village, collected folk tales, and they recorded and they published their folk tales in 1812, and these folk tales were given to the people for their reading. So this way, they tried to create a feeling of nationalism in the people. So it was the role of art and culture in creating nationalism in the people. नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल इज हंगर हार्डशिप एंड पॉपुलर रिवोल्ट. हंगर हार्डशिप व्हेन पीपल सफर्ड इकोनॉमिक हार्डशिप नो मनी नो जॉब्स नो फूड इन दैट केस दे ऑल्सो वेंट रेवोल्यूशनरी. रिगार्डिंग दिस वन केस इज मैंशनड हियर दैट इन 1830s द ईयर्स 1830s वर द ईयर्स ऑफ ग्रेट इकोनॉमिक हार्डशिप इन यूरोप. हाफ ऑफ द 19th सेंचुरी सॉ अ बिग चेंज इन पॉपुलेशन साइज ऑल ओवर यूरोप. इन मोस्ट ऑफ द कंट्रीज यूरोप वर मोर इन यूरोप मोर वर द सीकर्स ऑफ जॉब एंड जॉब्स वर लेस. सो पीपल वर रेडी टू वर्क ऑन लो वेजेस. सेकेंड पॉइंट पॉपुलेशन फ्रॉम रूरल एरियाज माइग्रेटेड टू सिटीज एंड टाउन्स टू लिव इन ओवर क्राउडेड स्लम्स. स्मॉल प्रोड्यूसर्स इन टाउन्स वर ऑफन फेस्ड विद स्टिफ कंपटीशन फ्रॉम इम्पोर्ट्स ऑफ चीप मशीन मेड गुड्स फ्रॉम इंग्लैंड. थर्ड पॉइंट टू दिस इज इन द रीजन्स ऑफ यूरोप वेयर अरिस्टोक्रेसी स्टिल इंजॉयड पावर दैट वी डिस्कस्ड इन एमरजेंस ऑफ मिडल क्लासेज आफ्टर 1815. इट इज द सेम केस enjoyed power peasant struggled under the burden of feudal dues and obligations. Taxes were pending on them, heavy taxes were put on them. The rise of food prices or a year of bad harvest led to a widespread poverty in towns and the country. Fourth point in this, in 1845 weavers in Silesia, It is also a revolution, short revolution, about 24 hours revolution. Weavers in Silesia, this located partly in Poland and Germany at that time, had led a revolt against contractors who had supplied them raw materials and gave them orders for finished textiles, goods, designs at low cost of the finished goods. They on June 4, the weavers on June 4 at 2 p.m. a large crowd of weavers emerged from their houses and attacked on the contractors' houses. In exchange, 11 weavers were shot dead. And last point to this is the year 1848 was one such year, that is food shortage and widespread unemployment brought the population of Paris out on the roads. Barricades were erected. Louis Philippe, who was brought back to power in France in 1830, was forced to run away. A national assembly proclaimed a republic, granted right to vote to all adult males about 21 years of age, and granted right to work. National workshops were set to provide employment and other assistance. Next article is the Frankfurt Parliament of 1848. Frankfurt Parliament was an important instrument towards unification of Germany. So let us see what had happened in this parliament. The events of February 1848 in France had brought the abdication of the monarch and the republic based on universal male suffrage had been proclaimed. In other parts of Europe where independent nation states did not yet exist, such as Germany, Italy, Poland, Austro-Hungary Empire, men and women of the liberal middle classes combined their demands for constitutionalism with national unification. They were the people who united. So now, in what way, what were their process, their activities? I have counted in points. First point, they took the advantage of the growing popular unrest to push their demands for creation of a nation state on parliamentary principles. That parliament should be there. A constitution, freedom of press, and freedom of association. Freedom of association means the people should be allowed to make group, whether political group or the social group. Second point is, in German regions, a large number of political associations whose members were middle class professionals, educated people, businessmen, and prosperous artisans came together in the city of Frankfurt. Frankfurt is a German city that time also, now also, and decided to vote for an all-German National Assembly. So this was also basically the revolution of middle-class educated people, businessmen, and artisans, people who were doing different type of art. So on May 18, 1848, 831 elected representatives marched in a festive procession to take their place in the Frankfurt Parliament, organized in the Church of St. Paul. They drafted a constitution for a German nation to be headed by a monarchy along a parliament. So, and when they put forward these demands to the king, Frederick Wilhelm IV was the king of Prussia. He rejected all these demands and opposed the National Assembly and declared it illegal. The parliament was dominated by middle classes who resisted the demand of workers and artisans and subsequently lost their support. In the end, king called out army and the assembly was disbanded. Last point to this is, now monarchs were beginning to realize that the repeated revolutions and oppositions to monarchy could only be ended by granting concessions and rights to the liberals, nationalist revolutionaries. Hence, in the years after 1848, the autocratic monarchies of Central and Eastern Europe introduced changes that have taken place in Western Europe before 1815. Thus, serfdom and bonded labor were abolished both in Habsburg dominion and Russia. Habsburg dominion, the regions which were under the control of Habsburg Empire. So, this is all about in this video and lecture, and I hope you are listening these videos and understanding. These are self-explanatory points. You can make your own notes also by listening and controlling the video. It will help you to prepare for your exams. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.